The idea to make N95 type masks from a 3D printer has really taken off. I'm joined now by Dr. Chris Wiles, who is the Hartford Hospital resident that had this bright idea and started this project. Welcome.
Thank you.
When we last spoke, you were showing us a YouTube video of how you do this, and you had a couple printers going, but now I hear you're working with the U.S. Coast Guard, MIT, and others. Tell us how it's taken off.
Yeah, when I started, I had about 4 printers. Now we have 15 here at a location in West Hartford and 5 still over at the hospital, so 20 total. I'm getting to collaborate with the U.S. Coast Guard, creating a testing facility there with some military capabilities, as well as, like you mentioned, MIT, Cleveland Clinic, Harvard, and UConn Stores has also been working with all of us to go through a lab system at Yale. So we all have a lot of people working on the same type of projects, and it's nice to have so much collaboration.
This would be one of the bright spots of the innovation that came out of it. I mean, how many masks are you making and where are they all going?
So far, we distributed about 960. I have another 1,000 or so items here. We're making masks, face shields, ear savers, ventilator splitters, negative pressure chambers, a whole variety of things, so as well as face frames to reinforce loose-fitting masks.
How are they working?
They're working surprisingly well. We have some initial testing data that needs to be further tested and confirmed, but it's pretty promising. We're seeing about N93 level, whereas that gold standard is N95. And if you wear these masks over a surgical mask, which a lot of people are doing for comfort and extra filtration, they can be as high as N98.5 from what our data is showing so far. But again, we have to confirm that. And so far, these are only approved for community use. But our goal would be to get them approved for clinical use as fast as possible.
Okay, so where are you using them now?
Currently, we have them at our 3 hospitals that I'm associated with. I'm shipping them to 2 or 3 hospitals in Boston, about 5 hospitals in New York, dentists all over the area, nursing homes throughout New England, all the way down as far as Florida. Some dentists and orthodontists are using them.
Right, so it's really helping, I know, with the struggles against the PPE, but as far as actually in the COVID unit, you're using the regular N95 masks.
We're not using these directly with COVID patients as of now. For now, we're stockpiling a whole bunch of them here as a last resort if we ever did have to do that. But for now, we're using them more in the community setting if possible.
Well, amazing just how much you've been able to do in a very short time and just incredible to see. Thank you so much for sharing.
I'm happy to talk to you. Thanks for having me.